am Samantha Jean Ross and I am going to perform tracheostomy care. This procedure allows us nurses to remove secretions to maintain a patent airway, to facilitate ventilation, to promote comfort, and to prevent infection. Of course, we need to assess the patient, assess the respiratory status such as the respiratory rate, depth, rhythm. Of course, we need to obtain the lung sounds of the patient, and of course, we need to note for any signs of breathing difficulty, and there. Then after, of course, we need to check for the pulse rate, the characteristics, and the amount of the secretion, and of course, the presence of incision, and the appearance of the incision. So now, of course, we need to identify the patient and explain the procedure, why the procedure is necessary to be performed, and why she is receiving this treatment, of course. So, good morning, ma'am. I'm your nurse, Samantha, for today, and I am going to perform tracheostomy care for you to prevent the infection and there. So now, of course, we need to plan for the necessary determine if the patient is a post-operative patient. Then, if she is, you may now check for it for the patient's chart and the administer the medical pain medication as advised. And of course, we need also to perform hand hygiene by washing our hands and use of alcohol. And there, and wear PPE or face mask if indicated. And of course, we need to adjust the level of the bed in a comfortable working position. Adjust the head of the bed into a semi-follower's position or 45 degrees rather. And of course, we need to remove to lower the side rails and obtain the necessary equipments needed for the working table closer to you so that you will not be interrupted or be there. Then, please be draped to prevent the linens to be soiled. And there. Then after, of course, we may now implement the procedure, which is the, of course, prepare the, put on the face mask and the face shield, of course. Put on the face mask and the face shield, and, of course, we need to also to, prepare the necessary equipment, the catheter, the tracheostomy care kit, which is the, contains the brush, the cleaner, the tip cleaner, the basins, the hydrogen peroxide, and such. If it is not available, you may use or gather the three basins, pour the hydrogen peroxide on the first basin, half enough of hydrogen peroxide and the saline water, and on the second, on the last two basins, use only saline water. Then after, we may now of course, after filling it, open the sterile brush tip cleaner and prepare it. And the cleaning tip, if it is not available, and open also the gauze pipe. There. And then after, We may now put on the gloves, the clean gloves. Then after putting on the clean gloves, if the patient has oxygen delivery device, we may now remove it from the previous procedure, the suctioning, together with the soiled gauze, and discard it on the appropriate receptacle. There. Then after, we need now remove hold the faceplate and remove the inner cannula and drop it on the Perrier's basin, which contains the hydrogen peroxide, and replace the outer cannula with oxygen delivery device, and remove the soiled clean gloves to the appropriate receptacle, and you may now put on your sterile gloves. After putting on the sterile gloves, then we may now clean the inner cannula by agitate the inner cannula with saline water and move it back and forth with pipe, and of course also with the hydrogen peroxide there, and moisten the cotton tip or the cleaner, dip it with the saline water, and clean the inner cannula and agitate it using back and forth motion there. Then after, we need now tap it on the inner side of the basin and place it on the gauze pad. And then after, we need now replace the inner tubing. Of course, clean the inner cannula, the outer cannula, with the cleaner brush there, to prevent also the infection. Then we may now replace the inner cannula and lock it. And there. Then after, if the oxygen delivery device is in use, you may replace it back. So now, applying the cleaning the tracheostomy care. Of course, we remove the soiled dressing, so we have already removed it. Now we may moisten the tip of the cleaner and gently clean it there. Then after, replace the 4x4 gauze there, making sure that it is in place there. And then after, we need now clean the, I mean, remove the tape or the twill and replace it with new ones. Remove this wheel here. Do not pull out the tape, not until the other, the new tape or wheel is already in place. And tie it using a square knot. Yeah. You may now remove the other wheel, the tape, and discard it in the appropriate receptacle. Then, now we are almost done with the procedure. We may now remove the soiled sterile gloves and discard it on the appropriate receptacle, as it is, this might be contagious or infectious, of course. And there, after discarding it, don't forget to perform hand hygiene before and after the procedure to prevent cross contamination and infection. And of course, also, we must not forget to remove the face mask and the face shield there. And there, of course, you need to reassess the patient's respiratory status, the response to the care of the treatment, of course, the respiratory rate, of course, check the lung sounds, the pulse rate, and document the procedure, the catheter use, if it has been used, and the duration of the procedure, the amount of the secretions, the color, the characteristic of the secretions acquired. And of course, we must not forget to document also if the cannulation has occurred, and if there are any signs of respiratory distress and abnormal findings, document it and refer it to the appropriate healthcare provider. So now that we are done with the tracheostomy care, thank you.